I actually didn't even know what human factors was when I first started. It was kind of the pathway that I took that led me to it. I would say I got exposure to engineering through my dad. My dad's a mechanical engineer. I was encouraged by my parents to, you know, ask questions, see how things work. I really liked psychology and engineering. There was a summer program called Emerging Ethnic Engineers, and that was an instrumental part for me starting out. The leader of that program told us that if one person fails, you all fail. Coming in as an A student, I was upset, and we all passed. For me, it just made me realize like how community can uplift each other, because I don't think that everyone was going to pass without us helping one another. Every opportunity, everything that I'm on, any team that I'm on, that's something that I care about. There's been a whole bunch of research that has shown that human error happens and that we need to have a focus on that. When you get into an environment that's different than the R&D environments that we're designing in, there's other factors that come into play. So it's not just the surgeon, it's also that resident or that medical student that they're teaching. So they're thinking different things. They have different models that they're used to. And I like understanding different perspectives, and I think that's a lot of what comes into play as a human factors engineer. There's a lot of moving parts. The types of people that are coming into these roles are different, it's changing. And I'm super excited about really uncovering the needs of these up and coming future surgeons so that, you know, we could be the person that they look to, like we could be the partner that they look to work with in the future.